it's the importance of being affected by other music as well. And this is another thing I always say is that, like, listen. You just can't ever take in enough. And it's lovely when it affects your songwriting, makes you write differently.
Absolutely. And that is also one of those songs where once she sang it, you know, same thing with Baby One More Time, you know, it just clicks. You know, I didn't know it was that of a song until she put her genius on it and took it to that place that only Kelly can, you know, or Britney. That's also, you know, that's when you get lucky, right? When you have the, you know, you find a soulmate sort of thing. And it just clicked.
And then from someone who's top 40 to a voice of someone like Celine Dion, is it a massive shift, or are you just applying skills that you've honed for years?
With her, it was, you know, I was a huge fan, and to work with one of the big, big voices of the world was huge for me and for Christian Andreas, who wrote it. And I remember she was, she came in and sang the song amazingly.
Yeah.
You know, she was... killed it, but you know, I had this particular way.
She just didn't do it twice.
I tortured her for a minute.
Yeah, but I remember being tortured by you.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Particularly hard. I like it though, I, as a singer, because I remember when I listened back to our song, I was like, oh yeah, this sounds great. So it's always worth it.
Yeah, I mean, she was such a super pro, and I think the song was maybe not what she was normally doing. I think she was like more of a big ballad. Girl, you know, so but yeah, that turned out so amazing.
I can read your mind, and I know your story. I see what you're going through. Yeah, it's an uphill climb, and I'm feeling sorry, but I know it will come to you. Yeah, and don't surrender, 'cause you.
Amazing reading, actually researching before this interview. It's so diverse. That is actually, other than the amount of hits you've had, the diversity is actually fascinating. Can you just like give us a Pink song and just tell us something about your collaboration with artists and how, you know, if there's someone out there who isn't an artist, but they want to start working with it, just give us something that, like, what is that magic ingredient of the partnership, the writing partnership?
I think one of the most important things is that when you're, whatever is an artist or a co-writer, is that, you know, we have this, like, saying that, you know, daring to suck.
Okay.
Like that you have to create a super safe environment where even if you and I are writing a song and I come up with like 8 bad ideas, you know, and it has to feel okay. Because the 9th might be great, might be the one that changes everything. So I think that's one of the most important things. Everybody feels safe in the room and that it's a friendly, collaborative environment. That everyone's in the room wanting to achieve the same thing, to hopefully achieve something great.
Yes.
And that takes, you know, a lot of trust and a lot of, you know, have to be open and all that. But really having the freedom to be bad.
Yeah.
You know, to feel like you're okay with, like, because you never know. I don't know how many times people say, well, maybe we should try it. No, maybe not. No, that's stupid. You know what? Let's not. Yeah. And you have to go like, no. What is it? Say it. And then they say it. It's like, that's amazing, you know?
Yeah.
And so you never know, you know, the mystery of creativity, you know, as we all know, appears in very different ways.
We have a good saying when we're writing as a band that someone comes up with something and you say, maybe we'll use that on the Lithuanian tour, which is, it's not very nice on the Lithuanians, but you know what I mean by that.
Yeah.
We'll shelve that for another day.
I have this thing where when I'm recording vocals, when they want to do something that I don't like, that's kind of like technical or super complicated, I go, that's great. You should do that live. Save that for, that's too good to be on the record.
Too good.
No, I don't know how many people fall for it. I think that's it's out there now that that's a thing, but yeah.
You took my hand, you showed me how. You promised me you'd be around. That's right. I took your words and I believed in everything you said to me. That's right.
Before we get to the musical, because it's the last thing I want to talk about, just talk me a little bit through. I am a big fan of your voice.
Okay.
You know, I love when people can really sing, and you do have an incredible voice. Just talk me through, as a songwriter, how that's helped you. Because I, without being disrespectful to any of the artists you've worked with, I can hear when you've produced the vocals.
Right.
There's a level of detail you get which isn't apparent when I hear other producers produce. Just talk us through how important that is for you, not as a, just as a songwriter, but as a producer, just to put that extra bit of something special on a record.
You know, being a singer, understanding singers, just the fact that you can give them tips about like, oh, maybe try this from a technical point of view is amazing. But I guess as a singer also you have, and a writer, you already have the vision in your head what it's supposed to be. Mm-hmm. And in to be able to sort of explain that, not in words, by actually showing kind of what it should be from my point of view.
And inspiring, I think, as well.
But to me, it's a melody can be sung many different ways, even if the same notes, and we all know this, we all heard different versions of songs. We all know how different they can be, meaning different things. So I think the detail comes in, to me, is like, I hear it a certain way where the melody is going to be, or the lyric or whatever it is just right.
Mm-hmm. It's like when I remember the first time I heard Raw.
Yeah.
It's that Raw. Yeah. It was like, that's Max.
Yeah.
I knew straight away. Yeah. And there was something on one of the Taylor Swift songs. I was like, that's Max straight away. Because it wasn't just notes. It was the way you arrive at notes. Mm-hmm. And it was only a singer could have done that.
Right.
Sorry, I've slightly gone off on a tangent here because I'm interested in this. I guess what I'm saying is it's the fine details, the real details, which most people would go, I don't even know what that bit is. But they've listened to it a million times. It's almost like part of the hook. I got the eye of the Is it like you've sculpted this song and now I just want to add more and more and more till you just can't be caught up in this song anymore? Is that the goal?
The only way I can explain it is that if I have, you know, and this is not every time, because, you know, there are singers you work with who then you show them and then they do something else and that's better. Mm-hmm. You know, it happens.
Yep.
And so I wouldn't say it's like always the same procedure, you know, but I think the easiest way for me to explain it is that it's almost like math to me, where it's like it has to be the right sum, the calculation needs to be right. If it's sung in a certain way, and then it gets you to feel a certain way.
I guess that's always the end result. Is how does it make you feel?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I just hear certain things a certain way, and again, sometimes some of the things that you've heard that I've done or been part of, the artists have done their thing.